police, but crashed on 75.
And so tonight, we're getting you answers about that bank robbery suspect at the center of this standoff yesterday. News 6's Terry Daniels went digging for information for you tonight and talked to the people who know this suspect. Terry, what'd you find?
Well, Sheree, his name is Jackie Jackson Jr., and this evening he's being held on a bond of $1 million. It all started with a bank robbery in Westchester, became a chase, ended with a long standoff on I-75 in Laughlin.
Approaching Glendale, Milford, still in the left lane, vehicle in excess of 80 miles an hour.
That's radio traffic from a Westchester police cruiser. It was during the chase that ended here with a crash and a tense three-hour standoff.
Lockland's advising that the suspect is pointing his weapon through the windshield at the subject up on the concrete berm now.
That weapon turned out to be a toy gun, but officers didn't know that, and neither did tellers at the PNC Bank on Tyler's Corner. This is a just-released surveillance photo showing the robber waving a gun, dressed all in black, wearing a black mask. Police believe that robber was Jackie Jackson Jr., who finally came out of the van and surrendered. Jackson was arraigned today.
I don't know him to be a mean guy at all.
Angela James lives across the street from the Cincinnati apartment that Jackson has lived in for several years.
I know the man and know the Lord, to be honest with you. You know, because when I did see him, if I'm not mistaken, he was, I believe, on his way to church. Okay. I'm not for sure, though, but I don't know where he was going, but I ain't at least expect that to happen.
Jackson will be back in court next Tuesday.
Law officers did fire several shots into that van, believing that was a real gun, a real threat. They're still investigating, but it appears that Jackson suffered a rib injury from the crash and not from a gunshot. He was treated and released from a hospital. Sheree?
You can only imagine how scared that poor teller was. All right, Terry, thank you. The complete coverage of this chase and the standoff is on our website right now. It takes you right up to the scene with a slideshow of the tense standoff and the suspect finally surrendering. You can find it all on our website. It's WLWT.com.